Can you feel it? Now it's coming back. We can steal it. If we bridge this gap, I can see you through the curtains of the waterfall. When I lost it, yeah, you held my hand, but I tossed it. Didn't understand you were waiting as I dove into the waterfall. So say that you're gonna know.
Hi, welcome to PNN. I'm Mark Hathaway. In our last show before spring break, we'll start things off with the 3rd through 5th graders on their recent field trip to a farm.
Tarragon Primary went to Green Gate Farms today. Let's see what's going on. Hey Nathan, what are you doing?
So we're cutting these dead plants so new plants can grow later on.
My favorite part was probably getting to see the goats and the pigs.
And the food.
No, I didn't really like it.
Don't sabotage me!
Actually, the food and the dogs.
The bunnies.
There's one big pig. He's
north? And he's scorch.
And he's like huge, the size of a buffalo.
So what was your favorite thing at Green Gate Farms today, Reese?
I liked all the animals, especially that big pig and the bunnies. And I really liked the dogs.
I like all of how you can just pick food off of the ground and eat it without having to wash it.
The pigs, and the horse, and the goats, and the bunnies.
All the animals and the vegetables.
Huge one!
We have a friend.
So the plants can grow well, and they're going to feed this to the pigs. So.
Yay!
Radishes,
whatever.
Everything tastes awesome, and the animals are adorable.
Oh, that's good.
Except they're horsey bites.
So what we're doing is we are weeding the kale so that the kale can grow and produce more.
Well, thanks, Sam. An alumnus from 2014 recently visited us. Let's catch up with them on our segment, Where Are They Now?
I'm Isabel Gonzalez from the class of 2012. I'm Blaisdell Olivera, and I graduated last year. High school's great, and it was a nice transition. It was fun. It's different. It's a lot of work and responsibility, but it was a pretty good transfer, I have to say. I made a lot of friends. Well, before Paragon, I was like at a really even smaller school. And so coming into Paragon like got me used to having more people, and the classes going to Savio, it was like, I don't know, it was a smoother transition since I had Paragon in between.
I think English has really, really helped me because it's been kind of rough, but all the grammar routines that we went through and how we had to learn everything with grammar in 8th grade and 7th grade and 6th grade and all the grades. It's really helpful in English because we don't even really do it anymore, but you still get points taken off if you make a mistake, so it's really helpful. So is math too.
Chemistry was a lot easier last year after Paragon.
Oh yeah, biology. Biology is really, it's easier. My favorite thing that I miss is either Girls Club in 6th grade. I have a lot of memories from Girls Club in 6th grade. Or lunches in 8th grade, because Miss Perkins was really cool and everyone would talk. And
Pirate Day maybe? Or Elvis Day. Those were fun. Oh, and Fridays. Fridays are great with the food and
listen, it was really great.
I miss Slurpees.
Oh yeah, we never get Slurpees.
Thanks, Blaze and Isabel. The 8th graders went on a physics field trip to iFly. Chris filed this report.
Hi, I'm Christopher, and we're with the 8th graders today at iFly, and we're going to see what they liked about it.
Available all the way down along the bench. Please leave enough room.
it was awesome. Like, since I haven't gone skydiving. Well, I really liked the fly high, which was where the instructor brought you all the way up to the top of the tube and then condensed himself so that you fell down. It was really fun.
My favorite part was definitely the high fly part where the guy took you up really high and you just get really scared that you're gonna fall and hit something.
I don't know, the whole thing was really cool. We went to the very top and it spun around. It felt like you were in a, it felt like your face was being squashed.
High fly was pretty cool because you get to fly, because that's in the name.
Oh, I liked when you went to the very top to the white part and then you came down. You weren't going that fast, but it felt like you were. So it's not for people who are afraid of heights.
It was really great. I was expecting to be scared, but I wasn't.
You were.
It was really cool.
That was so fun.
Oh my gosh.
It looks like the 8th graders had a lot of fun. For PNN, I'm Christopher.
Thanks, Chris. And finally, our second grade field reporters went on an investigative mission to ask first and second graders a very important question.
Hi, I'm Nadia.
And I'm Lauren.
We're here to ask these kids, what do you want to be when you grow up?
What do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to start a business for maybe exercise or something and do like...
That's a good answer. Like, what exercises do you want to do?
Probably, like, gymnastics or running or, I don't know, like, exercise.
I want to be an animal trainer since I like to spend time with my two dogs. What are the name of your two dogs?
Darby and Starla.
Those are cute names.
Well, what do you want to teach the dogs? Like, tricks?
I want to teach them things like how to roll over or how to share or shake.
A cheerleader?
Why do you want to be a cheerleader? What makes that special to you?
Because you get to cheer and I like cheering.
Basketball, soccer.
Basketball.
What color?
Blue.
Nice.
Zaya, what do you want to be when you grow up?
An artist.
And why? Why do you like art? Why do you want to do art? You like painting? Okay.
Wait.
Riley, what do you want to be when you grow up?
A marine biologist.
What makes that special to you?
Because I like marine life, and I like animals.
Hi, Isaias. What do you want to be when you grow up?
A scientist, of course.
Why? What does that make you... What is
inventions.
Nice.
Okay. And if you want to be specific about inventions, I'll give you this. Robots.
Nice.
Transforming robots.
Okay, next, Wyatt.
She touched it.
Hi, Wyatt. What do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be...
Ice cream.
Why? What makes that special to you?
I want to eat ice cream.
Nice. You like it?
I guess
you.
Yeah.
Vanilla. Looks like we've got some promising futures here.
I'm Nadia.
I'm
Claudia.
I'm Lauren.
And I'm Lexi.
Bye.
Thanks, second graders. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Now, to Bob with the weather. Tomorrow I predict the weather to be 69 degrees Fahrenheit.
Now, with Annabella to the weather.
Annabella with the weather. Ready and...
Wait, what am I saying?
Now to the weather with Annabella. Yeah, okay, ready and action.
Now to the weather with Annabella.
Hello, my name is Annabella, and I predict that they will be a high of 60 tomorrow because the stationary effect shall move only to Austin, right here, and they will be blue.
What the heck? I lost my map.
I thought it. I suspect it will be cloudy because it was cloudy today, and I'm pretty sure that the weather will the front hasn't moved too much, will not move too much.
It sounded perfectly round red.
This is the hugest. This is one of the
the biggest onions I've ever seen.
Say it again. This is one of the
rare. This is one of the biggest onions I've ever seen.
I got is it an onion?
No, it's a radish.
Why don't you say radish? Do it again.
This is one of the biggest radishes I've ever seen.